नमस्कार, माय नेम इज चंद्रशेखर पुसाळकर। आई एम वन ऑफ द ग्रैंडसन्स ऑफ दादा साहेब फाल्के एंड द फाउंडर ऑफ दादा साहेब फाल्के इंटरनेशनल अवेयरनेस मिशन। टुडे ऑल ऑफ अस नो दादा साहेब फाल्के एज अ फादर ऑफ इंडियन सिनेमा, बट नॉट एवरीवन इज अवेयर ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट ही वॉज अ मास्टर ऑफ मल्टीपल आर्ट्स बिफोर प्रोड्यूसिंग एंड रिलीजिंग द फर्स्ट फीचर फिल्म ऑफ इंडिया बैक इन ईयर 1913 बाय लिटरली फाइटिंग अगेंस्ट ऑल ऑड्स। एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ हिज पैशन, his persistence, his patriotism, his sacrifices and application of his multiple arts over 100 years ago, today India stands first in terms of annual film output in the entire world. In recent times, Indian cinema industry is producing over 1600 films each year in various languages of India. Dhundiraj Govind Phalke, alias Dada Saheb Phalke, was born in a tiny village called Trambakeshwar near to Nasik on 30th April 1870. Dada Saheb Phalke's real surname was Bhatt, not Phalke. Since his ancestor used to supply cut banana leaf to King Peshwa for serving food, and that process in Marathi was called making Phalke. Even there is an interesting story behind his nickname Dada. When he was enrolled in a high school in Mumbai, initially his school friend used to make fun of his name Dhundiraj by calling him Dhundi Dhondia, and Dada got fed up and he declared that henceforth I should be called as a Dada, and we all know that he became Dada Saheb later on. It is said that when Dada Saheb Phalke was born, he was born with curious and searching eyes, and therefore he was named as a Dhundiraj. Of course, Dhundiraj is one of the name of Lord Ganesh. Dada Saheb was brought up and groomed under a very religious atmosphere, as his father Daji Shastri was an eminent Sanskrit scholar and a main priest to the Trambakeshwar temple. Since childhood, Dada Saheb therefore was familiar with stotras and mantras. Dada Saheb also had an inclination of learning various forms of art since his childhood, like putting rangolis, making an attractive arrangement at time of festival, making a lantern in Diwali, and even he used to make Ganesh idols in Ganpati. Dada Saheb Phalke, when he was around 12 years of age, his family was shifted to Mumbai from Trambakeshwar since his father Daji Shastri took a job of teaching Sanskrit in Wilson College, Mumbai. Afterwards, for high school, he was enrolled in Maharashtra High School, Mumbai. And after successful completion of high school, he was given a 1-year drawing and painting course in Sir J.J. School of Arts. In fact, Dada Saheb's father wanted him to become a Sanskrit scholar like him, but his elder brother Bapu insisted that he should be put in art school, seeing his progress in various forms of arts. After completion of 1-year course in J.J. School, Dada Saheb was sent to Kalabhavan at Baroda since his elder brother Bapu was already settled over there. Kalabhavan gave different dimension to the life of Dada Saheb Phalke. Under kind guidance of Professor Gajjar, Dada Saheb Phalke not only learned drawing, painting, architecture, model making and photography, but he also went on to master it in near future. He became an S photographer. Initially he did the freelance photography, and later on he had a studio in Godhra near to Baroda. You will be surprised to hear that a creative person like Dada Saheb Phalke did the government job for 4 long years as a draftsman photographer, and he resigned that job to support the Wang Bhang movement, as he was influenced by the philosophy of Lokmanya Tilak. Dada Saheb Phalke learned different aspects of drama from Professor Ranade in Baroda, right from acting, direction to the stage arrangement. And later on in his life, he wrote one Marathi drama called Rangbhumi during his stay in Banaras. The creator of this magical world of cinema actually in real life learned the magic from German magician Karl Hertz. He not only learned it, but he mastered it and had a stage show in the name of Kelpa's Magic Show. The word Kelpa in Devanagari is a reverse of the word Phalke. Dada Saheb also learned printing technology techniques from Professor Walawalkar in Ratlam. He initially had a press in name of Phalke Art and Printing Press in Maroli near to Lonavala, and his press was doing photolitho job transfers for Raja Ravi Verma's press. Later on, he partnered Mauji Seth in Lakshmi Art Printing Press, and color printing and tri-color printing was a specialty of that press. The quality of the Lakshmi Art Printing Press was so high that only the Times of India could match it. Due to the differences with the partner in the printing press, Dada Sahib left the press and was thinking what to do next. And in that frame of mind, Dada Sahib was having a stroll on Girgaon back road in Mumbai with his son Balchandra, and he saw one movie called Life of Jesus Christ. This movie was a turning point in his life. While watching that movie, he imagined the Indian mythological characters like Sri Krishna in place of Christ and Meera in place of Mary. After watching this movie, Dada Saheb Phalke decided to make this industry Swadeshi. Obsessed by the dream of Swadeshi film, next few months Dada Saheb's schedule was very hectic. He literally had sleepless nights. Daily late night he was watching some new cinema in cinema house. He was hunting for the available material, reading material on the footpaths of Mumbai and in libraries. He was experimenting with the toy camera on the walls of his house. At this particular point, Dada was jobless and he had no other source of income. Therefore, he also sold some of the unwanted household things to finance his new dream. Dada Saheb Phalke toiled very hard for this project, but it affected his health, especially his eyesight. He almost became blind one day, but Dr. Prabhakar came to his rescue and cured him with caution. Dada Saheb Phalke back to his mission, and he realized that he needs some money to go to London to learn the technique of making cinema and to buy the necessary equipments, since nothing was available that time in India. Dada Saheb shared this thought with some of his friends and relatives, but instead of supporting, they just made the fun of his idea, and Dada Saheb was disappointed. But his old colleague Mr. Nadkarni came to his rescue and arranged for the funds against his insurance policy, and Dada Saheb went to London. In London also, Dada Saheb was helped by two key people. One, Mr. Kebban, the editor of Bioscope magazine, and second, Mr. Cecil Hepworth, producer and director of the Hepworth Factory. Due to their huge support, Dada Saheb was able to learn the full technique of the cinema making, and he also learned how to handle the equipments, and he came back to India after a successful tour of London. Equipments arrived from London, and Dada had a story of Harishchandra in his mind to make the films. But before that, he made one short film to attract the financier. The short film was called The Growth of Peace Plant. Through this film, he was able to show the full process of plant in just few seconds, and that was a miracle that time. He got some finance at that time, but that was not enough, and he was supported by his wife Saraswati Phalke. She gave her ornaments, and Dada started making Raja Harishchandra. The Growth of Peace Plant is the first scientific film of India. After getting money, even making Raja Harishchandra was not easy. It was a one-man show. It was a testing time. Dada was managing all the department except camera. He had a tough time training the semi-skilled, unskilled artists and staff. Finally, even the casting of the female role for the role of Taramati was the toughest job, because that time the acting by female artist on stage was considered as a below dignity. He even went to red light area and asked for the told the females, he gave them offer, but still they also refused, saying that we won't be part of such a downgrade business. So disappointed, Dada had to settle with the famine face of the male artist Salunke for the role of Taramati. So after crossing and facing all sort of hurdles, Raja Harishchandra was completed and it was released on 3rd May 1913 in Coronation Talkies, Mumbai. The film was silent and had subtitles in English and Hindi. After Raja Harishchandra, Dada Saheb also made two more films in 1914, Satyavan Savitra and Mohini Bhasmasur. And along with these three films, Dada Saheb went to London for the public screening. Dada Saheb was offered 20% partnership in the company along with £300 per month salary by the renowned British film producer Cecil Hepworth after watching his movies in London. But being a true patriot, Dada Saheb Phalke humbly refused this lucrative offer and returned to India, as he was more concerned about the turning the business of cinema into a big source of employment for the Indians. After successful tour of London, Dada Saheb came back to India, but the scene was totally different. He faced all sorts of problems, especially of working capital. Money lenders had stopped financing him due to the fear of World War I. Even getting a raw film was very difficult. So Dada was forced to settle on short films to keep his obedient and sincere staff busy, who were prepared to work on 50% salary. To overcome the financial problem, Dada Saheb also appealed to the newspapers to support financially to this upcoming struggling industry. But he got very poor response, and Dada Saheb was finally visited the princely state of Indore, Gwalior, Baroda with his first three films and some unit of operators. He was able to get some finance from the Maharajas of the states, and Dada Saheb started preparing for Lankadhan in 1917. Lankadhan was produced with very limited finance and resources. The unit members of Lankadhan had only 9 members. To save the expenses, even the role of Ram and Sita was given to Mr. Salunke, male artist, and Dada Saheb himself wrote a script and ensured that they won't share the same shot. This in fact is the first double role in the history of Indian cinema. Lankadhan, when it was released, proved to be a big blockbuster. This in fact is the first blockbuster film in the history of Indian cinema. In Na Cinema in Mumbai, it had a record collection of over 30,000 in 10 days. All shows were going packed houses, and show timings were right from 7 a.m. to night 2 p.m. In Pune's Aryan Talkies, the crowd was out of control, the gates were broken and police were summoned. The Chennai had a different story. The collection was so huge that Dada Saheb was forced to use the bullock carts to bring the collection from Chennai to Nasik under police protection. So Lankadhan proved that this new industry has money in it. After success of Lankadhan, Dada Saheb Phalke was bombarded with plenty of offers, and he, with the help of 4 industrialists, formed Hindustan Film Company. For Hindustan Film Company also, Dada made 2 commercial hits like Kaliya Mardan and Sri Krishna Janam. In spite of lots of ups and downs in his life, Dada during his career made 70 plus films, including 30 short films. His last film was Gangavataran, that was produced in 1937, and it was his only talkie film. Even during his last days, in spite of his ill health, Dada was dreaming to make animation film, and he shared that idea with his son Prabhakar, and with his support, the application was made to Government of India for obtaining license, because license was necessary due to wartime. The license application was sent in January 1944, but on 14 February 1944, Dada Saheb Phalke got a shock of his life. The license was refused to the father of Indian cinema, and shock was too much for him, and Dada Saheb Phalke left this world on 16 February 1944. Dada Saheb Phalke's wife and my grandmother, Saraswati Phalke, played a very vital role in life of Dada Saheb Phalke. Dada Saheb Phalke himself frequently had said that he would have not achieved his goal without her solid support. Saraswati Bai Phalke stood behind Dada Saheb Phalke in all his good and bad days. She not only gave financial support at the time of Raja Harishchandra by giving her ornaments, but she also lent him the technical support. She in fact is the first female technician of India. In those days, the films we used to get had no holes on either side, and that tedious job of punching holes was done by Saraswati Phalke in late night after finishing the work of extended family people of 50 to 60 people. She even learned how to develop the films, and at times she used to act as a reflector, standing in the scorching sun for the hours together, holding the white sheet in her hand. Saraswati Phalke was nicknamed as a Kaki in household. She not only gave her motherly love to her own children, but she also showered her affection to all unit members. She also used to act as a mediator between her husband and the outside world, because he was a very busy man and was not easily approachable. Dada Saheb Phalke, being a complete artist, was a perfectionist. He was very particular about the timings, neatness and cleanliness. He used to dislike half-done job and also leftovers on lunch and dinner table. Dada Saheb Phalke had no bad habits like smoking, drinking and gambling. He in fact was a workaholic and used to do the gardening even in his spare time. Even if he was a strict person, he was very loving father in his house and very caring boss on sets. Dada Saheb Phalke used to give equal treatment to all unit members, and the foremost quality of Dada Saheb Phalke was he never used to discriminate them on the basis of region, religion and caste. The lesson which all of us should learn from Dada Saheb Phalke's life is, if you want to become successful in your life, dream big, follow your passion, be confident about yourself at every stage in life, set the right goals, make a plan and start taking action. Remember, most of the times it's not too late in your life. A lot of times, the limits which you believe are the limits that are set by your own mind more than anything else. When you get rid of all such limiting thoughts from your mind and start taking action with a clear vision and rock solid confidence, you too can create history.